Hello everyone, this is Elke, and today's insight and recording are about finding and exploring your true self. At the time when we are born onto this earth, we are the closest that we can be to our true self, to who we truly are. Even though during our time in the womb, we already start to pick up on how our parents and especially our mother perceive life and the world around them. We are already beginning to make the first decisions about the world we are entering and our surroundings through the eyes and feelings of our mother during the last trimester in the womb. Many are already picking up if they are wanted or unwanted, the right or wrong gender according to their parents' wishes, if the world is a pleasant or unpleasant place to live in, and so on and so forth. A little child comes in very connected to and knowing very well who they truly are. They can easily see and connect with their entourage, guides, animals, and even nature. Until they are taught and told that it's not real, and that it's only happening in their fantasy. Over time, we become less and less connected to and aware of who we truly are. And the more we are integrated into the system, we start to take on certain identifications with the world, forming what is called our personality, ego, which equals our belief systems and all the boxes we have bought into, which then becomes our identity and who we think we are. The older we become, the more identities we take on. Again, according to our belief system and how we are taught we should be and behave, and how much we buy into it. We are taught that we are our minds and our body, so we start to identify with these, putting the mind into the driver's seat of our life, perceiving that the mind is the all-powerful master that has it all figured out. The mind, in turn, being in the driver's seat, tries to take control over the body, starting to send the body mixed messages, as it is taught by our society that the body is imperfect and constantly needs to be controlled and fixed. Additionally, our jobs, family positions, and everything else we do become part of our personality, as most people are identifying with the things they do and roles they take on. All of this conditioning, beliefs, and identities, combined with all the fear-based systems and the belief that we need to survive, which I personally find quite funny, as I see so many people protecting themselves and trying to survive, until finally, one day, they die without ever having truly lived, makes it very hard for us to stay connected with our true selves. Your true self, the totality of who you truly are, is so much bigger than just the mind, which literally is just a little grain of sand in the desert compared to your true magnificence. All the conditioning, the identities and fear-based systems are keeping you away from finding and exploring the truth of who you truly are. The magnificent and radiant being that has no judgment nor identities. The beautiful presence that just is, enjoying everything for what it is without labeling everything and putting it into a box. Finding and exploring your true self is a process that requires commitment to yourself. It requires an open mind, an open heart, and it requires the courage to question all the systems and conditioning. It requires stepping out of survival consciousness, knowing full well that you are eternal. It requires stepping out of the mind and into the heart. It requires letting go of all the belief systems, attachments, identities, and much of who you think you are. It requires the courage to dive into the unknown, which in reality is only unknown to the mind. To face your fears and step out of your comfort zone. So you will be finally able to meet that part of yourself that has been hidden in the shadows. Hidden by all the mind-ego created boxes, identities and systems. It begins with asking yourself the following question. Why am I doing what I'm doing when I'm doing it? Doing this will start to release all the gunk that has been stored within your subconscious mind and within your cells. It will help you to let go of everything that is not you, in turn making space for more of you to come in. It begins with consciously commanding your heart to open, feeling your own beautiful presence within your heart center and expanding it from there. Bringing in more and more of you, which in turn will raise your and your body's frequency, thereby opening you up to bring in even more of who you truly are. Opening up to the beautiful adventure of finding and exploring your true self and all of who you truly are.